Okay, well, I'm just going to introduce Keith Owen. And Keith is going to, and Keith is going to introduce all the acts in the Heart at Home concert. So, Keith, off we go. And, of course, Judah. Thank you.
Fine, ladies and gentlemen, this is the final segment of our day. Some people would call this the highlight, but others might want to make an early exit. Now, we have many, many talented singers to perform for you this afternoon. But before they arrive, I'd firstly like to introduce you to our first singer, a very popular Bournemouth second tenor, Les Salmon. Limp over here, Les. Come on. He had a knee operation on Friday. And he's here to see. There's the sympathy applause. He's going to, you can stand there, bro. Les is going to sing Maria. But Les was actually born in Sebastopol. Sebastopol, South Wales. Is that true, Les? Yes. That's true. Now, we move on to the section leader of our bass section. Jack Selway. Jack is...
Hey, well, Jack!
Jack is absolutely world class at gardening. But tonight, he will be singing. Just a very quick plug for Jack and his wife, Nikki. They have a garden open day on the afternoon of Saturday, September the 5th. It's an absolutely unbelievable garden, and it recently featured on Gardeners World. Amazing place. First 50 people will be accepted for the free visit to Jack's garden. So here he is, Mr. Greenfingers himself, to sing The Ballad of Joe.
Thank you very much. So Joe Hill needs some introduction these days. I'm going to give you a concise introduction. He's a Swedish folk hero. He's been honoured on Swedish postage stamps and is taught to this day in Swedish schools. In the early 1900s, he went to the States and he was appalled by the deaths and the injuries and the poor pay in the mines there. He campaigned for improvements, but became, as you can imagine, very unpopular with the mine owners. He was a songwriter. He scorned the clergy's promise to the oppressed of paradise in heaven, and he wrote the famous satirical line, you all know it, you'll get pie in the sky when you die. That's Joe Hill. One day, two people were shot in where he was living in the States. The same day, Joe went to the doctor with a bullet wound. Joe wasn't very helpful. He refused to say how he got that wound. The doctor reported him to the police. In a miscarriage of justice which caused international outrage, Joe was condemned to death by a firing squad. He died in Salt Lake City exactly 100 years ago. But he became a legend. In this ballad, his friend has a dream. The Ballad of Joe Hill.
I dreamed I saw Joe Hill last night, alive as you and me. I said, but Joe, you're 10 years dead. I never died, said he. I never died, said he. In Salt Lake City, Joe, said I, him standing by my bed. They framed you on a murder charge. I ain't dead, said Joe, but I ain't dead. The copper bosses kill you, Joe. They shot you, Joe, said I. Takes more than guns to kill a man, said Joe. I didn't die, says Joe, I didn't die. And there he stood, as big as life, and smiling with his eyes. Says Joe, what they can never kill, went on to organize, went on to organize. From San Diego up to Maine, in every mine and mill, where working folks defend their rights, it's there you'll find Joe Hill. It's there you'll find Joe Hill. I dreamed I saw Joe Hill last night, alive as you and me. Said I, but Joe, you're 10 years dead. I never died, said he. I never died, said he.
Now we move on to a chorister who's already had a medal, but we all now deserve a medal to listen to him. A man of many parts, some of which are his own. He's sung, this is absolutely true, Valerie will know this, he's sung in all four parts of the choir in the same time. The same song, and no one could take the wildest difference. Anyway, here we have Derek Gray singing the Aussie Barbecue.
I noticed this year we haven't had a barbecue, and I thought I'd sing you this little song to show you what you're missing. I did want Judy to accompany me, but she didn't know the tune either. But it goes something like this. when the summer sun is shining on Australia's happy land, round countless fires in strange attires and many an Aussie band of people looking grumpy as their lunch goes up in flames. From the smoke and the smell we could plainly tell it's barbecue time again. When your steaks are burning fiercely and the smoke gets in your eyes, when the snacks all taste like fried toothpaste and your mouth is full of flies, it's a national institution, Australian through and through. Come on mate, grab your plate, let's have a barbecue. Come on, mates, grab your plate,
let's have a barbecue.
The Scotsman loves his haggis, the French eats snails and frogs, the Greeks go crackers over their moussakas, the Yankees love hot dogs, the English love their roast beef, the Irish love their stew, but you just can't beat the half-cooked meat of an Aussie. When the steaks are burning fiercely and smoke gets in your eyes, when the snacks all taste like fried toothpaste and your mouth is full of flies, it's a national institution, Australian through and through. Come on mate, grab your plate, let's
have a barbecue.
There's a fly stuck in the artery, the bread has gone rock hard, the kids are fighting and the mozzies are biting, who forgot the aero guard. There's bullets in the esky, the beer is running out, and what you saw in Mum's coleslaw, you best not think about. When the steaks are burning fiercely and the smoke gets in your eyes, when the snacks all taste like fried toothpaste and your mouth is full of flies, it's a national institution, Australian through and through.
Come on mate, grab your plate, let's have a barbecue.
And when the barbie's over and you're safely home again, with a queasy tummy and a family dummy, many lonely hours you'll spend, you might get round to thinking, as many often do, come rain or shine, that's the very last time I'll have a barbecue. When your steaks are burning fiercely and the smoke gets in your eyes, when the snags all taste like fried toothpaste and your mouth is full of flies, it's a national institution, Australian through and through.
Come on mate, grab your plate, let's have a barbecue.
See you with the ladies next week.
told you he'd sing all four voice parts in one go. Now we move on to a member of our baritone section. Now, is it true that our baritone section are unjustly criticised?
Yes!
Would the rehearsal end 20 minutes earlier without our baritone section?
Yes!
Now, my mum used to have a saying, talking about criticism, my mum had a saying, before you criticise anybody, you should walk a mile in their shoes.
Yeah, yeah.
And that way, when you criticise them, you're already a mile away and you've got a pair of their shoes. So, on to our first baritone, then second baritone. What way are you singing, Derek? Richard Berry is now going to sing Hallelujah.
I was going to sing Homeward Bound, which is the title track of Rin Tavell's latest CD. But when Keith announced this, he said he wanted something entertaining. I don't think I could make that entertaining, so I'm going to do something else. But I'd like to say a few words, first of all, because I think the person who wrote it is actually greatly underestimated. I don't know if any of you are the same, but you know when you get those really down moments? I don't want to put a damper on the proceedings. But for me, there are two people who, through their writing, can actually get to the soul of things, and no matter how depressed or bad you feel, by the end of listening to them, you feel great. One of those is Brahms. And for me, the piece that does that is Brahms' German Requiem, which has successively higher and higher ecstatic musicality. And the other person is, I don't know whether he's known to you very well, but I'm sure you've heard of him. He's a Canadian singer, songwriter, poet, novelist. And I was going to bring a list of a few of his accolades and awards. But when I looked him up on the internet, it was so vast I gave up. But to give you an idea, he's been made a member of the Order of Canada, which is their highest civilian accolade. And he's written a number of songs, and he started back in the 60s. And I bought two of his LPs in the early 70s, and he's seen me through many a time where I felt like giving up. And the song that I'm going to sing, given that I discovered afterwards that we've got all these VIP very erudite, experienced musicians, I now feel as I'm on a sort of Hampshire version of Britain's Got Talent. I'm just hoping there's no Simon Cowell amongst them. The song I'd like to sing was written in 1984. It's had 200 covers in languages around the world and has sold over 5 million copies. It's Hallelujah by Leonard Cohen. I hope you don't get too depressed. I'm never going to sing it like Leonard Cohen, or Simon Cowell would immediately go, next. So I'm going to sort of do a different version of it. Incidentally, he wrote 80 verses of this before pruning it down to just four. And every time we hear him sing it, it's different. But I'm going to sing the core of three of the core verses plus the ending.
Hallelujah.
chair, and she broke your throne, and she curled your hair, and on another she blew the hallelujah.
From your lips.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Can anybody remember the year that Annie Get Your Girl was first performed on Broadway? Who was Annie? Annie? And who's the other person? No, you're singing it. Bye. Have a nice day. So we now have Annie and Frank to sing. Anything?
Now, don't get confused when you hear the words. Keith and I have been friends for years. Okay? So it's nothing to do with friendship.
Anything you can do, I can do better. I can do greater. Sooner or later, I'm greater than you.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am. Yes, I am. I can shoot a partridge with a single cartridge.
I can shoot a sparrow with my bow and arrow.
I can live on bread and cheese.
And only on that?
Sure.
That's so correct.
Any note you can reach, I can reach higher.
I can reach any note higher than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
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 No, you can't.
Yes, I can. Anything you can buy, I can buy cheaper. I can buy anything cheaper than you.
50 cents.
40 cents.
30 cents.
20 cents.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
Anything you can say, I can say softer.
I can say anything softer than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
No, you can't.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
I can drink my liquor faster than a flicker.
Well, I can drink it quicker and even sicker.
I can open any safe. You can sing, I can sing longer.
I can sing any note longer than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
In my coat.
In your vest.
In my boots.
In your hat.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
Anything you can say, I can say faster.
Well, I can say anything faster than you.
They can.
Yes, I can.
They can.
Yes, I can.
They can.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
I can jump a hurdle.
I can wear a girdle.
I can knit a sweater.
Well, I can feel it better.
I can do most anything.
Can you make a pie?
No.
Neither can I.
Any note you can sing, I can sing sweeter.
I can sing any note sweeter than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
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 No, you can't. Can't, can't.
Yes, I can.
Move on to a very brave man who will be accompanying himself on a ukulele. Now, the ukulele is an absolutely fantastic musical instrument to some, but it does have its critics. For example, one person said to me the other day, what's the difference between a trampoline and a ukulele? The answer is, you have to take your shoes off when you jump on a ukulele. And why was it a tragedy when the car crashed over the cliff with two ukuleles in the back seat? It was a tragedy because there was room for at least five more ukuleles. So without further ado, Bob Dury, to sing with his ukulele, Phil the Fluter's Ball.
I've got to have my words just in case. It's only the second time I've ever done this in such a big audience. I'm honoured that you're all here and you give me a go. It's an Irish tune that was about the 1920s that used to hear my father sing it just after the Second World War. and I got rather fond of it. And since I've started playing this a little bit, I thought I'd do that. We have a sing along, and there's a chorus. And it's some of you probably know it. With a toot on the flute and a twiddle on the fiddle-o, hopping in the middle like a heron on the griddle-o. Hop down, hands around, crossing to the wall. Oh, hadn't we the gaiety at Phil of Porter's Floor?
It's easy, Mark.
Hope so.
It
falls off
the tongue.
Here we go, folks. If you can sing in a bit, try and get this chorus going. With a toot on the
toot and a twiddle on the fiddle, oh, hopping in the middle like a heron on the griddle, oh, down, hands around, crossing to the wall, oh, hadn't we the gaiety of Phil the Fiddler's Ball?
That is a chorus, so we go into the other bit. So it's
have you heard of Phil the Fluter from the town of Ballymock? Times were getting hard with him, the man was almost broke, so he gave out a notice to his neighbours one and all, as how he'd like their company that evening at the ball. When writing out, he was careful to suggest to them that if they found a hat convenient at the door, the more they put in, the better would the music be for battling on the floor.
There we go, folks. With
the tunes on the flues and the tunes on the fiddle, popping in the middle like a heron on the grill.
There was Mr. Dennis Rockety, who kept a running dog. There was little Crooked Paddy from the Turlocky Bog. Boys from every barony and girls from every yard, and the beautiful ladies O'Hara's in their private handcarts. Along with them came bouncing Mrs. Rafferty. Little Nicky Mulligan was also to the fore. Rose, Susan and Margaret O'Rafferty, the pride of Ballybunion and the pride of Bettlethorpe.
With a jingle on the flute and a twiddle on the fiddle, popping in the middle like a heron on the griddle. Clump, clump, hands around, crossing to the wall.
First little Ricky Mulligan got up to show them how, and then the widow Cafferty steps up to take a bow. I could dance you off your feet, says he, as sure as you were born, if you will only make the piper play the berries in the corn. Phil plays up to the best of his ability, the ladies and gentlemen begin to do their care. Hey there, Mick, it is you that has the agility, and the Gora Mrs. Cafferty has left him like a hare. With a tune
on the flute and a twiddle on the fiddle, popping in the middle like a heron on the griddle, one down, hands around, crossing to the roar. Oh, have we the gaiety and fill the filters fall?
Thank you.
Wow.
Eclectic. Now we move on to the top tenor. A man who is known for his eloquence and words of wisdom.
That'd be top
tenor. I particularly cherish his following sayings. The first one. A day without sunshine is like night. Or, this struck me particularly. Consciousness, the annoying time between naps. Here he is, the man himself, Lol, performing. Master of the house.
Welcome, my friends. You sat yourself down. Now make the best innkeeper in town. As for the rest, all of them crooks, looking the guest as crooked the books. Whom do you see? Honest men like me. A gent of good intent, who's content to be. Master of the house, don't catch a eye. Have the left with us and don't think by. To the left, master to the right. Ready to relieve them of a soup or two. Watering the wine, making up the weight, picking up the knickers when they can't see straight. Everybody loves the landlord, everybody's bosom friend. How it all increases, being a sense of days in the end. Oh, no, no, not for the house. Catch your eye, never was a fuss about the passing by. Enter, my friends, lay down your load, unlace your boots and rest from the road. Things weigh a ton, travel's a curse, but here we try to lighten your purse. Here the goose is cooked, here the fat is fried, and nothing's overlooked till I'm satisfied. Food beyond compare, food beyond your beef, mix it in the meat and pretend it's beef. Kidney of a horse, liver of a cat, filling up the sausages for this and that. Residents are more than welcome, private suites occupied. Reasonable charges plus some little extras on the side. Charge for the mice, eggs for the mice, 3% for looking in the mirror twice. Here's a little slice, there's a little cut, 2% for sleeping in the window shut. When it comes to fixing prices, there are a lot of tricks he knows. How it all increases, all the bits and pieces. Jesus, it's amazing the only group. Master of the house, we can get you right. Never want to pass a bargain, pass it by. Soon to the top, back to the beat. Comfort for life, a lifelong meat. Everybody bring companion. Give him everything he's got. Give him lots of Jesus, mommy, what a sorry little lot.
Now we move on to another top tenor.
Oh, that was good.
So, We move on to Mr. Kirby, Roy Kirby, on his own, singing about a canine.
By himself.
However, you know, I criticised probably unjustly baritones earlier. What baritones and basses, what do you think of top tenors? Poser. In fact, Margaret, last Wednesday, said to me, so Keith, how many top tenors does it take to change a light bulb? I said, I have no idea, Margaret. How many top tenors does it take to change a light bulb? She said, it takes one top tenor to change a light bulb. The top tenor holds the light bulb, and then the world revolves around it. Okay, Roy, on your own, sing about canine.
Thank you very much, Keith. I need to give you a little bit of background about this song. It's called The Whippet, written by a man called Eric Boswell, who most of you will never have heard of, but I guarantee that you've sung or listened to at least one of his songs. And he wrote it for Gracie Fields, and it was the Christmas song, Little Donkey. Anyway, he tired of writing songs for pop singers, we went to the Northeast and started composing what might be called contemporary folk songs. And this is one of them. Now, whippets and whippet racing was a very popular pastime in the northern towns in the last century. They were smaller than greyhounds, didn't take up as much room, didn't eat as much, and when their racing days were over, they made a good household pet. Now, the races used to take place on what were known as flapping tracks. And the only explanation I have for this is that at the start of the race, the dogs would be held by a friend of the owner at one end of the track, which was just a piece of waste ground on the edge of the town or village, and the owner stood at the end of the track and he waved or flapped a handkerchief or a bit of rag. So flapping tracks. So this is the song about the whippet, and I need to get in costume for it. Now, I was going to dedicate this to David Levy, to remind him of his northern roots. Because his grandparents were not the Whippets. He doesn't talk about it an awful lot, but I know. He tries to keep it secret. Anyway, I brought the Whippet with me. Now, I've got to warn you, she's a bit nervous and shy, so I don't want any raucous catcalls or noise whatsoever. I'll just go and get her, so bear with me.
And it shows up on the track. But when she gets her contact lenses, man, you'll never hold her back. I've got a little whippet, she's a wee bit slow. And what it is about her, I just don't know. She'll never be a canine churl, Cole, you will agree. But I love that little whippet. And she loves me. I've got a little whippered, but never won a race. I've got a little whippet that the pussycats all chase. Her two front legs are rather short, her back one shorter still. So even on the level ground, she thinks she's running up a hill. I've got a little whip, but she's a wee bit slow. And what it is about her, well, I just don't know. She'll never win a prize at Crufts, I think you will agree. But I love that little whip. And she loves me. I've got a little whippet that never won a race. And what it is about her, well, I simply cannot trace. I used to dream of having racing trophies on the shelf. But it's no good my racing her. I find I always win myself. I've got a little whippet, she's a wee bit slow. And what it is about her, well, I just don't know. She'll never win a prize at Alton Show, you will agree. But I love that little whippet, and she loves me. I've got a little whippet, I took her to the vet. He said she's the most gorgeous whippet he has ever met. But he said, in my opinion, I'll tell you what you need. A little pair of crutches would most certainly increase her speed. I can see her winning races now, she'll bring you untold wealth. And with a bit of luck, you'll get the crutches on the national health. I'm sure he's right, I'll get her fitted. Just you wait and see. For I love that little whippet, and she loves me.
It's a song that was previously performed at the Heartman's Voice Choir concert tour in Portugal when we were as a trio. It's a song conducted dozens and dozens of times by Amy Yanks, and I hope we can do it justice today. It's piece is entitled A Darling, which in Welsh means the picture, and it's a tribute to the painting by Albrecht Dürer, who in 1508 drew the world-famous Praying Hands. And Welsh lyrics, when translated into English, are: two hands beseech me in the picture. When I go to sleep, these hands are beside my bed. And when morning comes, a quiet breeze will take my prayer to the stars with the sweetness of the nightingale. So here we have John Evans. Where's John Edmund?
He's
behind you. And John Taffy Brackenborough. Mike Morgan. And me. And this is called A Darling, but listen to this accompaniment. Just to get his mic first.
for all you've done, Eamon. Thank you very much.
About it.
So,
so it's been great to see you all. You all seem to have enjoyed yourselves. It's been lovely weather, wonderful setting, and very nice and relaxing. And another Harvard Boys Choir event to remember.
See you in 40 years.
So farewell. Travel home carefully, and look forward to seeing you. Most of you on Wednesday. Cheers.
I'm just tired of it.